Hello and welcome to this webinar about harness the power of database for IoT edge device data management. This is a joint webinar presented by Toradex and ITTIA. My name is Stefan Eichenberger and I work as a field application engineer at Toradex. With me today are Sasan Montaseri, he is the founder of ITTIA, and Ryan Phillips, who is a software architect at ITTIA. Please note that we have a question and answer session at the end. Feel free to enter your question in the question dialogue of GoToWebinar. We like to hear your feedback about the webinar, therefore we will do a short survey at the end. The recording will be made available in the next week and it is recorded therefore. Now, let me briefly introduce Toradex. Toradex is a system on module provider, which is focusing on high reliability and long-term maintenance. We provide free PSP support during the whole lifetime of our products. And we provide also a huge ecosystem with articles and a partner network, of course. Toradex was founded 15 years ago. We have today more than 3,000 active customers worldwide. We have 100 plus employees in 9 global offices. And we have more than 50 proven partners like ITTIA, which is with us today. As I said earlier, we are spread all over the world. This means you have direct sales support. And you can contact us in almost all languages. You can find our products in various application and industries like communication, robotics and automation, and so on. Our product portfolio consists of two families. This is first the Apalis, which is focusing more on high performance systems, where we have the faster processor, like the new IMX8. And then we have the Colibri family, which is focusing on good price performance ratio, where we, for example, have the new IMX8X available somewhere next year. Okay, that's already it from my side. Now I'd like to introduce ITTIA, who is a powerful database provider. And I would like to hand over to Sasan Montaseri.
Thank you, Stefan, and hello, everyone. My name is Sasan Montaseri. I am the founder and president at ITTIA. I am with Ryan Phillips, who is the product architect for ITTIA DB SQL. ITTIA provides database software and services for developers of embedded systems and devices. We closely work with customers from initial prototyping all the way until they complete deployment. Our database and experience purely relates to devices and systems with special characteristics. And our goal has always been to share our software and experience openly so customers can benefit from our decades of experience and focus on their innovation. ITTIA DB SQL is cross-platform, supporting variety of operating systems. Data and data management are more important than ever, as devices must consistently provide interoperability across heterogeneous systems. Whether you are measuring temperature, pressure, or motion, a large volume of data needs to be stored, managed, and analyzed in real time. When you build and deploy devices within an IoT system, you need to look at data management options that support standards, offer data sharing protocols, APIs that allow scalability, protocols for security, and features that prepare your device data to be always highly available. At the same time, developers prefer to benefit from their database knowledge and not spend months and months to learn data management tools and techniques. SQL, standards, and common database features make device data management practice less complex while they make data interoperable between devices. As your system design require more intelligence, IoT data management must handle the increased number of devices. As you add more devices, data management need to provide scalability so your designed IoT system can handle adding larger number of them that can communicate and become aware of each other. Then, data that originates from sensors grow into a network of connected objects, and as the number and complexity of IoT devices deployed increases, data management architecture gains more importance, and managing IoT device data becomes an important challenge. During today's webinar, we will share the fundamentals and specific tips for industrial IoT systems data management that we have learned and believe to be important. We will show you an IoT demo for which some of important data management challenges and options will be shared. The effect of important characteristics such as data security, interoperability, scalability, and standard will also be presented. You will witness how an embedded relational database helps to protect device data and make it easier to secure and monitor device data than purely relying on the cloud. We have built a demonstration, and we will share how verified hardware software easily come together to collect, store, analyze, and distribute data. We will share how our solution with the right tools assisted us to accelerate development, reduce development cost, and risk. You will also see how relational database management software library can greatly impact the interoperability between devices and ease the system maintainability. The right height performance relational database simplifies data management for developers with SQL features not typically available on an embedded device. Elegant APIs, tools to ease development, and smooth upgrades make it fun to build applications, independent of operating system. The combination of off-the-shelf computer on module and application-specific carrier board with the right database and compatible operating systems offer a complete platform for building IoT end products for device applications such as medical, industrial automation, aerospace, robotics, and more. The demo that I referred, source code, will be available for your download. You can simply visit ittia.com/demos and select Smart Energy and the Toradex demo. It's available in a source code format for your evaluation. When it comes to complex IoT systems, we recognize the importance of data management capabilities on edge devices. From industrial automation and building management to city infrastructure and transportation, everything around us is increasingly becoming controlled by devices that collect data, mostly from sensors, to automate and improve our lives. As a result, more than ever, things connect, and the volume of data generated by devices such as metadata and sensor readings is exponentially increasing. These sophisticated chips embed in objects, each collect and transmit information, and integrated devices interact like you and I and analyze a wealth of IoT data. They even make important on-the-spot decisions. To keep up with IoT data management challenges, not only do you require database software on edge devices, you need the means to connect devices and distribute data. Before we explain the technologies which come together to manage the IoT data demonstration in our lab, let's look at the data management options. Sensors and devices may connect directly to the cloud, where data is centrally managed, or devices may locally collect, store, and analyze the data, and then share the selected findings or information with the cloud. While there's a tremendous emphasis on the promotion of cloud solution, which promises strong security, devices can deliver the best security by never sharing the complete data at all. Performance, maintenance costs, ownership of the data, and robust connectivity all motivate edge device data management. Manufacturers building industrial automation, medical devices, automotive, power grid, or any other system all face the same challenge to harness the incredible power of device data management. But this new era introduces a hidden risk. When do you take data analysis out of the cloud and put it on the edge device? When it comes to building a system with edge devices, you need few things, including a development board, operating system, compiler, database, and a way to distribute and share data. You also need to decide whether to manage the data on the edge or only after sending it to the cloud. Sensors and devices can connect indirectly through the cloud, where data is centrally managed, or send the data directly to other devices to locally collect, store, and analyze the data, and then share the selected findings or information with the cloud. Relying on the edge device for data management offers peace of mind by privately securing the most valuable data and reduce bandwidth costs. It also provides a great performance, lower maintenance cost, and ownership over the data. Embedded systems largely benefit and are empowered when data storage and analysis capabilities are locally available, so the bulk of data acquired by IoT device can be managed locally and only selected information is communicated with the cloud, using protocols such as REST, MQTT, and DDS. On-device local data management offers collecting, analyzing, and taking action from the real-time data without depending on any connectivity. Many IoT devices are built for deployment in hostile environment where relying on connectivity may be risky, and when connection to the cloud fails, device cannot collect and manage data, so operation stops and cloud solution fails. In a typical IoT scenario, sensors produce a large volume of data for edge gateway devices to collect and analyze, allowing the device to gain intelligence. To face the challenges and understand what a typical developer encounters, we decided to build an embedded IoT system in our lab. These high-performance systems not only need to collect data in real time, but they also need to make the data organized and available for other systems. The demonstration that we developed simulates a family of industrial IoT products based on ETIDB SQL database and Toradex Calibri customized single board computers that monitor energy consumption of a factory. We used four Toradex Calibri IMX6ULL modules with Aster carrier boards, one touch display, and the Linux operating system, as well as ETIDB SQL to manage and distribute data. These devices can gain intelligence, analyze information, and make decisions. The data management process starts with the device that facilitates communication with the common IoT data management platform and makes all software components work together. Like other potential applications of IoT technology, we made sure that our demo uses a variety of physical devices that collect data and communicate with each other. Our goal was to confirm that the edge devices can reliably collect, store, manage, and distribute information on their own. Hardware for IoT devices ranges from low-powered microcontrollers to fully functional embedded computers and microprocessors. In some cases, a dedicated human-machine interface is required to report the status of other IoT devices, provide detailed insights, and offer control. A device data management platform stores, analyze, and distribute data without relying on a central storage. Now, let's look closer to our IoT demonstration for which devices not only collect data in real time, but they also make the data organized and available to other devices. In addition, a connectivity solution enables a device to share its finding with other systems over a variety of network configurations. The core operating systems, programming languages, and other development tools provide the foundation for distributed computing. The theme for our demonstration is to utilize IoT to save energy and reduce energy cost, and as energy efficiency and cost are major concerns for factories. Our demonstration is focused on how to achieve these great savings with electric microgrid products that leverage our IoT data management framework, offering the right system on module. The factory's electric power grid is a local energy grid disconnected from the traditional grid and operate autonomously. A power grid for which its energy is renewable by resources like solar panels, energy storage systems such as batteries, or fuel-based generators. This makes it possible for a factory to operate using its own local energy generation, both in times of crisis, such as power outage, and to reduce energy costs. Like other potential applications of IoT, our electric power grid uses a variety of devices that collect data and communicate with each other, such as power meters, solar generators, and batteries. And when connects to a traditional power grid, it shares and receives information from the utility company, such as the best time to buy energy or use battery power. The data management process starts with a device that facilitates communication with the common Internet of Things data management platform and makes all software components work together. To create our electric power grid, we knew our software must be developed to monitor power, load, and ensure that energy production meets current demand. Energy storage systems, such as batteries, should be used intelligently to maintain a stable power supply. This required an awareness of how energy is consumed, both time of the day and category, in the same way that an automobile must monitor wear and tear on various parts, or a factory must monitor production rates. This requires us to build a system that stores and queries data across multiple dimensions. Automation is an important key to scaling IoT device data management because it quickly becomes impractical to monitor and manage all of the devices manually. An administrator should only need to step in to intervene if something unexpected happens. We started our demonstration to run and simulate data when sensors were connected throughout the system. Data was shared between each high-performance Toradex edge device, collecting a large quantity of data that in real-time example would accumulate data over many months and years. The edge devices also run a web-based dashboard that end users access to monitor the flow of data, so they can decide how various systems in our demonstration and devices are running and when they notified by alarms. Our goal was to connect each device to an object to make it intelligent and enable it to exchange information with other embedded systems and devices. Data was recorded in the local database files, including the data produced and consumed by each IoT device deployed. Again, these devices were designed to communicate with each other and monitor sensor data over days, weeks, months, and even years. Because the data was stored in a database, it was also possible to draw a graph for any desired range time, and each point on the graph represented the recorded data was found by searching the database, which saved a large quantity of data on flash storage media.
Now we will present a live demonstration of the factory microgrid scenario running in our lab. As you can see, sensors have been simulated to measure three important categories of energy consumption: electric vehicle charging stations for company vehicles, assembly line robots responsible for manufacturing, and other equipment such as servers. On-site power generation, such as wind, is also monitored and recorded. Each sensor device saves reading in a local database file on flash media. This ensures that historical data is preserved and available even while devices are temporarily disconnected. A new record is added for each sensor measurement at a configurable sample rate. By storing a complete history of power measurements in device local databases, the application securely and reliably maintains a complete record with high accuracy. The databases are then used to extract a small number of records at specific times for analysis and data sharing. By recording the sensor data to local databases on the IoT Edge network, it's possible to search through the data with SQL to perform machine learning and subject the sensor readings to analysis. This information will help the factory to understand and manage their energy needs. To analyze the data, there are several approaches available. We chose to implement a simple human-machine interface that presents the current state and history for each sensor. The interface combines a REST web server and ETDB SQL replication server into a single C++ program. Concurrent requests are handled safely and efficiently with database transaction isolation, which ensures that every task has a consistent view of the database. The electric power grid HMI can query the full history of sensor measurements collected by the power reader component, so that the HMI and power recorder can operate independently. Each program keeps its own copy of the local history tables. Database replication is used to send data from the data recorders to the microgrid HMI. This ensures that the data recorders are never overwhelmed by many requests, which could impact their ability to record new data. At the same time, the HMI can accumulate data from multiple data recorders on many different devices, enabling this solution to scale up to support a greater number of power meters. Now, ITTIA SQL is a high-performance edge device database for industrial IoT applications. It tightly integrates into applications to store a large quantity of data on flash storage media using strong built-in data types to clearly organize information. The current state of each sensor is saved in memory tables, while sensor history is collected permanently in disk tables. The hybrid ITTIA SQL database containing these tables is queried whenever a web client requests an update. High availability in ITTIA SQL also enables the application to be decentralized, providing a secure data management on each device, which can operate with or without connectivity. Now, most tables were configured to replicate data by the C++ application code, and options to change policies for data conflicts are also available. Let's look at the replication settings in ITTIA SQL for the measurement table. We have options for changing policies and dealing with data conflicts. All of this is very configurable on the fly in utilities like this, and these settings can also be altered directly within the application with C and C++ code.
So thanks a lot, Ryan and Sasan. We are now in the Q&A session. So I would like to first ask the following question. How exactly does the high availability work in the ITTIA DB SQL?
Thank you, Stefan. In ITTIA DB, high availability is accomplished using database replication, which can store data either to duplicate database on local flash media, or can communicate the data to other databases on other devices, whether that data is being kept on disk on each device or kept in memory on some devices.
Okay, perfect. Thank you. Then the next question is, what are you doing to secure the IoT devices? So I think that's a hot topic today.
Yeah, the database is able to secure the data in a couple of ways. We have a storage encryption that allows the application to encrypt the data with an AES encryption key when it's written to the storage media, so that if the storage media is removed from the device, it cannot be accessed by other applications. And the remote access to the database and replication is protected with SSL TLS encryption, as well as passwords that are communicated using the SCRAM authentication protocol.
Okay, perfect. Then I have another question. Is this demo that you have shown earlier also applicable to other Toradex modules, like let's say IMX 7 or IMX 8 in the future?
Yes, the demonstration is fairly lightweight and is built mainly for the ARM architecture that's common to each of those. And we can prepare target images for any of those boards, or even just provide iPackage files that can be deployed to any compatible Toradex target.
Okay, perfect. So they should contact you directly if they have any questions regarding other targets.
They can go to ITTIA.com/demos.
Perfect. Yeah. And then on the same topic, how long do you think would it take to make such a demo image for another target? So only time wise.
The recent versions of Toradex, it should be fairly simple. For the older images that were based on the Linero tool chain, we can still provide something for that, but we would have to build a new image for those.
Okay, perfect. Thank you. Then I have another question. Can you maybe explain how the demo is using replication?
In this demonstration, we set up several development boards, each deploying a different component of the factory simulation. And we configured those to all replicate the data that they're collecting locally on the board to a central database on the device which we connected the display and ran the HMI on.
Okay, so the central database was basically the one that had the display attached then?
That's correct. And that device was also running the wind simulation, but we had other devices running the data collection for the robot arms, EV charging, and the other equipment for the factory.
Okay, perfect. And then the second question is, does ITTIA DBSQL support QNX?
Yeah, we do have support for both QNX 6 and QNX 7, as well as a number of other real-time operating systems.
Perfect. And there I have a similar question. Do you also support bare metal OSs, or better talking, no OSs used? So if someone wants to do some bare metal.
It is possible to use the database with no operating system. The database would act as a single user library in that scenario. So you can have your one task alternately reading and writing to the database. And the only requirement is, if you want to store the data persistently, you need to provide a block IO interface into which the database can write and read blocks of data.
Okay, so you wouldn't need the file system then, or would you need any way?
So, you can either provide a single user file system as the underlying storage, or you can directly write to flash media, SPI flash, and the like.
Okay, perfect. So someone is asking, how this keeping a copy of the database works, and if it doesn't create a lot of network traffic because you have to synchronize all the databases between each other, and how big the database actually gets.
So in this demonstration, the database files are growing fairly slowly. It's only adding new data points once per second for each data point. And while that data is all sent over the network, in this demonstration, and you can configure the replication so that only data in certain tables is replicated. Since this is all logged into the database before it's sent, you can control when those exchanges happen. So in this demonstration, the devices are all
connecting every 4 seconds or so, so that we get a nice smooth display of the graph. But you can set it up to communicate less frequently to reduce the bandwidth. Really you want to look at the requirements for the specific application and whether it makes sense for all of the data to replicate like we do in this demonstration, or if you can segregate certain tables that are really of highest value to communicate.
Okay. Yeah, there is one question regarding data recorder and how you ensure that the data recorded are not repeated.
The database is basically taking whatever data it's given, and it keeps track of what records it has already propagated to other databases. So each time it initiates an exchange, it checks to see what's new and what has already been sent, and skips over any records that have been sent previously. So it's really up to the application to decide which records it wants to insert or update in the tables that are enabled for replication. And any other tables application can use without the information being replicated. So in summary, it's really up to the application to make that determination and then use the database in the appropriate way.
Okay, perfect. Then one question is, if the replication is using SSL TLS to make the network secure.
The replication supports SSL TLS, which encrypts the communication can also use certificates to validate the identity of the replication peers against the certificate authority.
Okay, perfect. So I think that's almost everything. I don't see any other questions. I would like to thank Sasan and Ryan for this webinar and everyone for attending the webinar. And yeah, I would like to close now. Thanks a lot for joining.
All right. Thank you very much.